everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Reaction Therapy. I am your resident psychotherapist, Tom Stevens, here to break down the lyrics to some amazing music. And you have entered an amazing week. This is the week where we give away song requests. We had a contest, for those of you who don't know, at our 50K live stream, where we asked questions about me, about Nick, about our show. And the people who answered first got to request their very own song for me to react to. And this week, all week, we're going to be reacting to your music that you pick. So they actually jumped, because they were at the live stream and they answered these questions, to the front of the line of requests, because we have hundreds of songs waiting in line to react to. But these are going to be so fun. I can't believe, just artists I have no idea of, and artists we have not, I don't think, maybe one of them we've done before, but I'm not sure. Up to bat first here, Billie Eilish. That's right. I've never done Billie Eilish before. In fact, I don't think we've done a woman as a reaction before. So I'm super pumped about this. It's called Happier Than Ever. I have to say thank you to all of you. I know I do this all the time, but I really am grateful that you'd watch the show, that you would comment, that you would subscribe, that you would share it with your friends, and that you would continue to come back. So thank you so much for doing that. I love breaking down these lyrics from a mental health perspective and doing a little bit of what I do every day at work, here at home with you every day. So without further ado, let's get into Billie Eilish, Happier Than Ever.
When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true.
So, when I see Happier Than Ever, I'm thinking, just so content, you know, just in a nice, peaceful life. Everything's great. Everything's going good. And the first thing that she says is what? When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. But how many of you felt that way, right? In a relationship where you're like, oh my gosh, every time I get around them, it's like I've got food poisoning. I can't stand it anymore. And you've been in toxic relationships, or you've been in situations where it's like, how come I'm happier without them and miserable with them, but I can't seem to stop that? So I'm curious to see where this story goes, but sometimes we need to admit that who we're with are actually toxic with us. Hope I'm not reading too much into this.
I wish it wasn't true. Give me a day or two to think of something clever, to write myself a letter, to tell me what to do.
This is really cool. It's very seductive music, right? And she's just sitting there on the phone talking. I didn't realize she was going to be saying the words in her song on this old school phone, by the way, that I grew up with the cord and everything. So I love that part. And her voice is amazing. I've not really heard any Billie Eilish music, unless maybe I watched a TikTok with one of her sound bites in it. But I don't really know her music or her story. But I would love to hear a little bit more, because when she's telling this, it's almost like talking through a relationship. And it's like she's talking to that person. And the idea that she said, I would love to write myself a letter to tell myself what to do. Like, I don't know what to do, but I wish I could give myself some good advice.
You skipped my avenue when you said you were passing through. Was I even on your way?
Just questioning the relationship, right? Like, what a great song. This is just one, like I said, I wouldn't go on a jog to, but one I would just sit back and listen to, especially with the feeling that she puts in it. Of just the reminiscing of, you know, would you even bother like to stop to see me, to plan to see me? Or it's like she's just talking out loud about what she already knows is true. And you can relate to this too, many of you, of relationships. And is this just am I being strung along here, or is this just not working and one person's trying harder than the other?
Was I even on your way? I knew when I asked you to be cool about what I was telling you. You would do the opposite of what you said you'd do, and I'd end up more afraid. Don't say it isn't fair. You clearly weren't aware that you made me miserable. So if you really wanna know when I'm away.
I don't know what the dripping is there. Unless it's tears that are supposed to be falling, but there's some kind of drip there. And, you know, just the realization, this is depressing, right? It's a beautiful song, but it's depressing in the words because it's speaking the truth of what's happening in her relationship, in that, you know, she's actually convincing herself, or at least saying out loud, that, you know, you didn't really care anyway, and this wasn't your priority, and it doesn't really matter to you anymore. And it sounds like it does matter to her, but there's nothing she can do because he's gone.
I know when I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true.
Like there's some kind of leak. There's got to be a bathtub that's overflown or something that's infiltrated the electrical system, and something's about to happen here. And I feel like the song will change course or something, but she's noticing like something's going on. Wow, what symbolism there of her opening the door and there was water the whole time just waiting to rush in and flood her away. So I have no idea what this is about here, but this is kind of scary.
You call me again, drunk in your Benz, driving home under the influence. You scared me to death, but I'm wasting my breath.
Man, this is a desperate feeling, right? She does great with this imagery of her having to swim out and not even able to get air. Like she's underneath all the water, trapped in this place where she's in a home basically that's flooded, and trying to swim her way out. And the whole story behind it is like, you're calling me up, you're drunk, you're not yourself, and scaring me, but it's the same old story. And, you know, almost the drowning feeling, like I've got no way out. I can't get out of this anymore. And you're desperately, if you've ever tried to swim like that, desperately to get to the surface or desperately to find a way out, you know, that trapped feeling of, you know, I cannot get out of this. And that's the same as the relationship. Like, I know this is bad for me, but I'm still in it.
You scared me to death, but I'm wasting my breath, cause you only listen to your fucking friends. I don't relate to you. I don't relate to you, no, cause I'd never treat me this shitty. You made me hate this city, and I don't talk shit about you.
Great. Oh, man, this is really good. She just totally switched things up, swam out of the house, climbed up on top of the roof, which to me is victory. Finally, I've gotten above the water and I am good to go. And I'm going to stand up for myself now, and I'm going to speak to you what you need to hear and hopefully stand up for herself. But I would never treat me like you've treated me. And, you know, she is pissed.
Cause that's just embarrassing. You are my everything and all that.
this is really something because I'm hearing two different things. Number one, it could be a relationship for her that she was all in for and got treated so poorly and just thrown away. And you talk about talking about yourself on the internet and putting words out there, or gossip, or just trashing somebody. But I also think this could be said for her about her fans, that not fans that like her, but the fans that talk stuff about her. And she does this for people, for the fans, for people to hear. And then there's so much hate sometimes out there. I picture that with some of these entertainers, that they have a lot of fans, but they also have people that try to bring them down. And I could hear an entertainer saying these very words about the people. It's like, why you gotta be so mean? Like, why you gotta talk like that? Why you gotta put me down? Why you gotta treat me that way? Because I'm not here to treat you that way. Just gave up her whole life for this relationship, you know? That concept of like, I did everything I possibly could for this relationship, which probably, by the way, isn't healthy all the time. Understand what codependency is and, you know, enmeshment, and learning that you tend to give up your life in an unhealthy relationship, tend to give up your life for the relationship. So that relationship here becomes the heartbeat. And if the relationship is bad, then you're bad. And it should not be that way. There should be a relationship and yourself separated so that you are separate from that relationship. You want it to go well, but it is not your lifeblood. And that's where she's saying, I shut everybody out. I did everything I possibly could. And look at this. Look at where it is now. And just so miserable. Made all my moments your own. Just fucking leave me alone. It's just enough already. Leave me alone. I love earlier when she said, don't waste the time I don't have. Like, I don't have the time to mess with this. So don't try to waste the time I don't have. It's just not even a part of my life. So it doesn't even matter. But just leave me alone, kind of, you know. And she's happier never without any of this drama. Just fucking leave me alone. But you can hear the screaming in the background, you know, that she's just up there screaming as loud as she can. But I think also dancing doesn't seem miserable at this point at all. And by the way, when you finally see that you're in something toxic or you're in something that's unhealthy for you, that's a relationship, that's work, anything that you're involved in, it could be family, that you need to break free from, not just let go of forever, but just create space from or get out of. Then sometimes it's very freeing to say, you know, no longer under the chains of that. I'm not going to let that bother me anymore. I'm not going to be sucked back into that anymore. And I'm going to go look for healthier outlets. Remember, eating, sleeping, exercise, balanced living, be able to go out for a walk, read a book, listen to music, hang out with people that are good for you, and you'd be surprised how much happier you can get. I just have this flash of like, she goes back into the water and swims right back down to the same room to get sucked back into the same thing. And I'm praying that that's not the way that this one's going to end. Like, oh, well, after I just said all that, I'm going to go right back into it. Did that mean she went back into the water to go back down into the same old life? Or does that mean she just washed herself free and she was moving on to some new life? I just do not know what that meant. I'm taking it as she's finally free and she's not going to go back to that old lifestyle, I pray. That's what I tell clients in my office. So thank you so much for recommending that. That was just insane. By the way, shout out to MS Chaos, who was the one who won this request by answering one of the questions at the live stream. So MS Chaos, this is for you. Great song choice. Billie Eilish, Happier Than Ever. I'm not sure how it ended. I can't wait to hear what you have to say, but wow, what a song and what a video. Incredible melody that goes into some rock and roll, and what a just mysterious ending. So thank you so much for doing that, MS Chaos. Once again, I appreciate the request. Appreciate you being at the live stream, answering the question first, and I cannot wait to do some more Billie Eilish. Remember, this is not real therapy. If you want therapy or need it in your community, please go to the links in my bio. Look out for some resources there. They can help. This is not real therapy. It's just me talking, but I love talking and I love breaking down the lyrics to these songs. So thank you for being here. Like, subscribe, pass this on to your friends. Give me your comments about what you think happened in this video and what you think about my insight in this video. And I can't wait to see you on the next Reaction Therapy.